click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, I welcome you all to this video. We are with the 10th chapter of Microwave Engineering. So here we are having the topics regarding the microwave transmission for the signal with the help of strip lines and the microstrip lines, the type of transmission lines here. So we started to see a comparative of both these transmission lines. So I hope it is very, very clear that the microstrip lines are essential modifications from the strip lines by discarding one type of the ground plane at the top position into the strip lines there. So now the central conductor that used to be in the strip lines is at the top position. So it has dielectric substrate beneath, and now there it is a backing above ground plane. So only one ground plane there it is. We have solved two selected problems corresponding to these strip lines and microstrip lines. Now let us add some more details with respect to the determination of characteristic impedance for microstrip lines. So here we start with our topic, characteristic impedance of microstrip line. So when we talk about the microstrip line, the major application, the major use of microstrip line is to have interconnection with that of the high speed logic digital circuits. So these are high speed logic digital circuits. So for these circuitry, we have the interconnections made possible with the help of microstrip lines here. So now here in this particular topic, we have the objective to determine the characteristic impedance that in general we represent capital Z sub 0 and measured in terms of ohms. So this is to be calculated for the microstrip lines. So very first of all, we shall see a schematic diagram that has a cross-sectional view regarding the microstrip lines. So in this schematic diagram, we have here, this is the strip conductor now which is at the top position and that used to be at the central position when it was used to be with the strip lines in general. Now here we have the width of the strip conductor denoted by W here, whereas the thickness of the strip conductor is denoted by small t. So here below this strip conductor we have the dielectric material. The dielectric characteristics of the material are represented by the relative dielectric constant epsilon r here, whereas the dimension of the dielectric material that separates the strip conductor from the ground plane that is expected at the bottom is represented in general by small h here. Sometimes it is also referred to be by small b here. Now when it is a time to have determination of the characteristic impedance Z0, so that time from the schematic diagram we come to have the information that the Z0 is a function of strip conductor width denoted by W, the thickness of the strip conductor denoted by T, the distance that is separating the strip conductor from the ground plane that can be represented by H here, the homogeneous type of the dielectric material separating the strip conductor from its ground plane that can be represented by epsilon suffix R here. So it seems that the determination of the characteristic impedance is quite complex. Many of the methods have been proposed so far to have the determination of characteristic impedance at accurate level. So one of the method that it was popular to is named as evaluation by the field evaluation. The field equation here we have, field evaluation method we can say. So this field refers to the electric fields and that of the magnetic fields that in the terms of wire circuitry we sometimes refer to the voltage and that of the current also. So The evaluation of these components, EH or in terms of voltage and current, if you see, so as the field evaluation method is extremely complicated, so therefore the alternate way is to have the indirect method. By the indirect method, we have a comparison of the microstrip line with respect to the another type of microwave transmission line. So let us have the another schematic diagram that gives you the cross-sectional view for wire over ground transmission line. So this is the schematic where we have the cross-sectional view here. The circular cross-section is for the wire. So let us say the diameter of this wire that is carrying the positive potential, let us say it is represented by V0 level at this particular position, and this is the ground plane. The ground plane is at zero potential. So this is V0 potential, and here it is zero potential. Now we have at the ambient position the dielectric constant represented by epsilon r, and the center of the central conductor having a circular cross section. To depth of the ground plane, we have the separation denoted by small h here. Now for this transmission line, which is called as wire over ground or wire over ground plane transmission line, the characteristic impedance is already formulated. The characteristic impedance is given by the equation Z0 is equal to 60 divided by square root of epsilon r in multiplication to a natural logarithm ln over a ratio. The ratio is having 4h into the numerator, whereas small d is in the denominator. The small h, small d have been already represented along with the epsilon r in the recent schematic diagram. The condition that the equation is satisfied is for we have small h, that is the center of the central circular cross section conductor, to that of the ground plane represented by h is very, very greater than that of the d here, which is diameter of the circular cross section for the central conductor here. So let us say this is the equation number one. To this particular equation, we shall be having comparative modifications. So the equivalent attributes we shall be deriving corresponding to the microstrip line, and the final expression for the Z0 can be obtained there. So for making the changes into the equation number one, we have to consider very first of all the effective and equivalent values for the first factor, that it is epsilon r, that it is the relative dielectric constant of the ambient medium. So here the direct dielectric material is not mentioned to be beneath the wire over ground, that it is in the transmission line, and at the top it was expected to be the air medium there. So we have to consider this factor to be having homogeneity also. The next factor can be small d. The small d is the diameter of the central conductor over the wire over ground transmission line. And now as we want to have the formula for characteristic impedance modified for microstrip line is having the strip conductor having a rectangular cross section. So while having the consideration of small d, we need to get shifting in terms of the equivalent parameters from circular cross section to that of the rectangular cross section. So when we talk about the first parameter here, the first parameter, we can say the determination of effective dielectric constant. The effective dielectric constant now can be represented either by epsilon suffix e double f or epsilon suffix r e in general. So r is for the relative, it can also be written over here. So now for the homogeneity of the dielectric medium, the propagation delay we shall be first of all considering here. So it is in terms of the measurements of time here per unit length, and now can be denoted by t suffix d here, d for the delay into the time here. So now it is given in terms of square root of the multiplication of mu into the epsilon, where mu is permeability of the material here. So permeability is nothing but how much a given material is giving a passage to the magnetic field through it. So it is measured in terms of Henry per meter. The standard value for the air or free space is represented by mu 0. It is a constant value. 4 pi into 10 raised to power minus 7 Henry per meter is its value. Whereas epsilon is the permittivity. So permittivity is how a dielectric medium or any medium is permissible to the flow of electric field through it. It is measured in terms of farads per meter. For air or free space, we have the value 8.854 into 10 raised to power minus 12 farads per meter here. Now let us say this equation for the propagation delay is represented by equation number 2 here. So as discussed, if we have the free space medium, so in free space we can denote the propagation delay by that it was t suffix d. Now in the suffix I add f here. So now for this representation of the symbol, we get modification into the right hand side here. So instead of mu, I put mu 0 into epsilon 0, I put under the square root here. So we know the constant values. It is 4 pi into 10 raised to power minus 7, as just now we have discussed, and this one is 8.854 into 10 raised to the power minus 12 here. So here we have capital T suffix df is equal to square root of mu 0 epsilon 0. When we use these values to substitute in this particular equation, we get the computed value of propagation delay time in the free space medium is equal to, we have it, 3.333, that can be measured in terms of nanosecond per meter. Sometimes it is also measured with respect to the dimensions in feet here. So that time capital T suffix df is obtained to be, we have the value 1.016 in terms of nanosecond per feet here. So let us say the representation is equation number 3 here. Now when we consider a non-magnetic type of material, so that time the representation of capital T suffix D will be is equal to the value, if we have in terms of feet here, so it will be 1.106, the equivalent to the earlier representation in terms of nanosecond per meter, in multiplication to the square root of epsilon r. So here it will be in terms of nanosecond per feet here. So let this can be the equation number 4 here. So now when we have to make a derivation corresponding to the effective value of relative dielectric constant, so it should be taken for the relative dielectric constant for the onboard material here. The empirical equation here we can give in the form, here I write the empirical equation. So it is epsilon suffix re, the effective here, it is equal to 0.475 times epsilon r added with 0.67. So let us say this is the next equation, equation number 5 here. So in this equation I mentioned epsilon r is relative dielectric constant, and this is with respect to the representation that we have already made in the schematic diagram of the transmission line here, whereas epsilon suffix re is the effective relative dielectric constant. So as just now we have gone through the equation represented equation 5, we have the two types of the relative type of the dielectric constant here. So let us have a comparison with respect to both of these constants with the help of this graph here. So in this graph, onto the horizontal axis, we plot the relative dielectric constant epsilon r, that it is initially there, and the effective value that we calculate by the use of previous equation that we represent here onto the vertical axis, epsilon suffix r e here. So now for the horizontal axis and the vertical axis, we start at this corner with the values 0 for both of the axes here. So whereas we have the markings 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 onto the horizontal axis, whereas we also go for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 onto the vertical axis. So to see the increase into the value of original relative dielectric constant epsilon r, we find increase into the epsilon r suffix e, the effective value here. But to see the additive and the multiplicative terms onto the right hand side for the epsilon r here, we come to see in the extent that we have rise into the epsilon r, that much of rise we don't find into the effective value, but of course it is a rise, so therefore we find such a linear graph here. So for this particular linear graph, we have the equation can be represented here, epsilon suffix r e is equal to 0.47 times epsilon r added with 0.67 here. So this equation will be very very helpful while we shift from the circular cross section having the wire over ground transmission line to the microstrip line here. So now the main part, the second factor, is to have transformation of the factor small d representing the diameter of the circular cross section. So here I mention the point transformation of a rectangular conductor from the equivalent circular conductor. So transformation of a conductor shape I mention. So in this regard, there can be another empirical equation. So the empirical equation for such transformation can be given in the form small d is equal to, we have 0.67 times w in the bracket 0.8 times added with small t divided by w here. So in this equation, small d is the diameter, whereas w is the representation of width of the microstrip line, whereas t is the thickness of the microstrip line here. So let us say we continue by numbering it to be the equation number 6 here. So in this equation, onto the left hand side, we have a parameter from the wire over ground transmission line, whereas T by W is the parameter from the microstrip line. Now when we get this W to the denominator of dW, so we have here D divided by W, and now here we have the factor T divided by W. So if we have a plot corresponding to these two ratios, we can compare better how a transformation can be made into the conductor shape from the circular to that of the rectangular. So in this regard, we have a plot here where the horizontal axis is the mention of T divided by W. We start with the markings 0, 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, 0.5, 0.7 here we have, 0.8, 0.9 and finally 1.0 here. So in the similar fashion, here we have the ratio D divided by W. So we start at 0.1, it is 0.3 here, 0.5, 0.7, 0.9 here we have, 1.0 and then up to 1.2 we can go. So we obtain such a relationship between the two ratios T by W and D by W here. So the equation, it was D by W is equal to 0.67 times 0.8 added to the top T divided by W here. So from the earlier two empirical equations, and the another knowledge, if we make a substitution, the substitution from the equations number 5 and the equation number 6 to the equation number 1. So equation number 1 will apply. So here I mention from equation 5 and 6 into equation number 1, we get the form of the characteristic impedance for the microstrip line. So Z0 is given by, we get 87 divided by square root of epsilon r added with 1.41, which is in multiplication to the natural logarithm, having the square bracket in multiplication to, that it is 5.98 times small h divided by 0.8 times w added with t. So this is the equation obtained by the researchers in this domain, and it is for the condition that we have small h less than 0.8 times w here. So let us say this is the next equation number, equation number 7. So this equation number 7 is most possibly thought of for the narrow width, the transmission line, that it is microstrip line here. So I mention here the type of microstrip is narrow microstrip line. As the equations with respect to the characteristic impedance and another parameters have been obtained by having the several times of experimentation with the given transmission line here, most of the time we come to know that the ratio for the thickness to that of the width, if you take W, so the experiments were holded true for 0.1 value of thickness to that of the width there. But when we come to have the thickness increasing with respect to the width of microstrip line, and when it is approaching 80%, so at the 80%, the validity of this characteristic impedance equation is somewhat doubtful here. So for the narrow type of the microstrip line here, this was the characteristic impedance equation available to us. And now, as a performance parameter with respect to the phase velocity or velocity of propagation, if you can see, so it is simply V is equal to C divided by square root of epsilon r suffix e. So epsilon r e is the effective relative dielectric constant, and C is the velocity of light into the air or free space medium. So the constant value can be substituted 3 into 10 raised to the power 8, which is divided by the square root of epsilon r suffix e here. So as this is velocity, it is to be measured in terms of meters per second here. So let us say this is equation number 8. Now, as equation number 7 is for the narrow type of microstrip lines here, for the wide type of microstrip lines, so I mentioned wide microstrip lines, we have the characteristic equation, the characteristic impedance equation modified to the form where we have h divided by w in multiplication to square root of mu divided by epsilon here. So here it can also be written in the form 377 divided by square root of epsilon r e here, or epsilon r in general, divided by h divided by w here, provided w is very very greater than that of the h. So in that case only we can say that the microstrip line is wide microstrip line here. So let us say this is equation number 9. So this was some more detailed information with respect to the characteristic impedance parameter for the microstrip line transmission line. By the next lecture, we shall be having a practice of simple problem for determination of the characteristic impedance value. So I hope you enjoy learning the topics of microwave engineering. For more such information and the details, you can subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you.